Now, why were we able to compete with strategic buyers? Because all we are is money. We weren't bringing any synergy along with us. Well, the reason is it had to do with the structure of Universal, and it had to do with the real internal synergies, not the imagined synergies that people roll out when they're trying to justify an acquisition, but the real synergies that existed within all the Universal all the Universal assets. Remember, most buyers didn't want all the assets. So by them, they did have synergy when they bought something, real synergy, but they were destroying existing synergy. So by the internal synergies of these assets being kept together, and there were huge legal and tax problems with breaking up the assets that were massive, and we'll talk a little bit more about that. We felt we could brand the we could leverage the Universal brand and the cross-media breadth to create a lot of unique value. And just a quick example of the synergy. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this, but just so you understand a little bit how these businesses work. Television production and channels, it's obvious, right? You produce, you put them on. Film, it's obvious, right? You got film product, you're going to show it on the cable channels. Well, what about music and film? Are there any synergies? The fact of the matter is, there are huge synergies because both sell shiny round things to retailers. So by combining those and having one distribution, worldwide global distribution vehicle, remember most of the revenue in film and music, 40% is generated in the US, 60% is generated outside the US. So these are big global businesses and you need this big distribution system. So by having unduplicated distribution systems and having one distribution system, you can save close to $100 million a year by combining that. Then, to use the appropriate term, how important are you to the retailer? Well, by being the biggest software provider to the retail industry, you're very important. You can negotiate better terms, you can get better placement, end cap placement of your product. There's a lot of good that comes from having that kind of mass. So those are some examples of the synergy which you probably wouldn't think about between film and music. In addition to that, every film has a soundtrack. The soundtrack promotes the film promotes the soundtrack. In the top 20, there's always soundtracks in the top 20. In addition to that, there's another very important piece of the music business called music publishing, which is a nickel and dime business, but a huge nickel and dime business. And that is, the guys who write the song, every time it's played, every time it's sold, gets a nickel. I'm exaggerating, that's not the right number, but they get a little bit of money, and they split that with the music company. The best publishing rights that exist today are the publishing rights for songs in film and television. It's gold. And there was a studio who tried to sell their music publishing rights to their library, and you know, everybody looked at it and was very anxious to buy it because they see every time it gets played, they get paid. And I think it was generating about $40 million, this was a few years ago, $40 million a year. They ended up taking it off the market because the growth prospects were so high they couldn't get paid for it. So that's another synergistic opportunity between film and music. So that's just some examples. And on the video games, a big article in The Economist this week about how important the film business is to the business, where the top titles, many of the top titles are film related. So all of these are very synergistic together. And I'm talking about real synergy, not the imagined kind.